Hi there, welcome back to another Crypto Update video. It's Monday, which means another staking rewards update video. This is for week 42, so we're well into the last quarter of the year now, 21st of October today. And as always, before we jump into the figures for the last week, just to bring you up to date, make you aware of any changes. And the good news is no big changes this last week. As you can see down here, we're still waiting to buy back Stellar, so I'm still waiting for a re-entry price once I sold 10,000 Stellar a few weeks ago, probably about 3 weeks ago. And now no big changes apart from that. A few of the coins have seen some little spikes up in price. I didn't really do any trading or selling or anything like that this last week, so things have just ticked along quite nicely. I did actually move my main stake machine, so it was offline for a short while, a few hours, as I moved it between offices, but everything's back up online now. So I did notice actually after I kind of moved it that I was receiving quite a few orphan stakes for the first sort of 24 hours or so, but everything seems to sort of be back to normal now. So it may just be that with some of these wallets it takes a little while to connect to the required number of peers. So if you're not connected to many other kind of wallets, many kind of peers on the kind of network, it can mean that your stakes are slow to kind of propagate in the network, and they then get orphaned. So I think that's probably happened with a couple of these kind of coins, but everything seems to be back on track now. So let's jump in and have a look at the figures for this last week, starting with Navcoin, as always at the top of the list. So 10 coins this week for Nav worth 83 cents, 9 Syndicate worth 1 cent, 0.614 NeoGas worth 75 cents, nothing for SmartCash. We won't receive anything until our Smart Rewards at the end of this month. 8,117 Metrix, so a nice big stake for Metrix this week, worth $1.29. 6 PIVX worth $1.51. Really good week for PIVX actually this last week. And the week before was pretty decent as well. So seems to have kind of picked up a little bit. I didn't know, I was a little bit worried that maybe I was on a different chain, but I do seem to be on the same chain as the official kind of Explorer. So it's just been a decent kind of week. I don't know if there's been maybe a wallet upgrade and a few people have been slow to kind of upgrade and have them been kind of forked off. But receiving a few PIVX stakes recently, which is nice to see. 475 Helix, really good week for Helix actually staking as well, worth $1.22. Now Helix had a decent spike up in price. It probably doubled in value about 4 or 5 days ago. I haven't actually sold any yet. I tend to track my prices using CoinMarketCap, so I have a watch list. And unfortunately, Helix isn't on CoinMarketCap, so you have to go into kind of CoinGecko or something like that to have a look. It's currently traded on Crex 24, so I may look to get rid of a few coins next time there's a bit of a spike. So I must make a bit of an effort to kind of keep an eye on the price of that. Vulcano, nothing for Vulcano, nothing for Bulwark. So a little bit disappointed both of those this last week, because we had some pretty decent weeks recently. 0.74 Stellar worth 5 cents, and finally Icon, 11.42 Icon worth $1.87. really good week for Icon. This is a nice steady kind of like staking coin, so as long as you have Icon in your kind of wallet. I use the iConnex wallet, which is like a Chrome extension. It just kind of cold stakes and a decent amount, so 11.42 worth $1.87, a nice amount for that. So a grand total this week of $7.53. If we jump over to the chart, you can see basically exactly the same as we were last week. So this may be, maybe this kind of like level is a kind of like new norm for us. As I said, we did have a pretty decent week. Nice big stake for Metrix, $1.30 odd, and a slightly better week than normal for kind of Helix. So a lot more coins and a little bit of an increase in price midweek has helped that. But everything else just ticking along kind of nicely. Looking forward to kind of like buying back Stellar once it reaches a level that I'm kind of happy with. But I'm not going to just jump in and buy back kind of soon. Because you're only getting 1% inflation, it's not a big issue if I'm out of the market for 3, 4, 5 weeks even. So I'm not particularly bothered about that, but we've still got a few thousand coins, so 3,500 coins, so still receiving a small amount. But once that goes back to sort of 13,000, 14,000, be a little bit better. But yeah, overall quite happy with things and the way they're going at the moment. No big kind of changes. As I mentioned a few different times, a lot of these kind of small coins I will kind of like look to get rid of. So Helix is a good example. If I'd been aware of that big pump up in price, I might well have got rid of a chunk of these kind of coins midweek. But whenever there's a kind of like a spike up in price, you know, I will take advantage of that if I kind of can and get rid of some of these kind of coins. The trouble with a lot of them, you know, you've got like Bulwark, Vulcano, Helix, Syndicate, stuff like that, is that they are very low cap coins and the trading volume is very, very low. So sometimes even with a big spike in price, you can't actually take advantage of that because there's just not enough trading volume to get rid of your coins, which is a little bit of a disappointing. But I will try and take advantage of big spikes up between now and the end of the year. And then, as I've mentioned, a lot of these coins will be disappearing from the both the staking and masternodes experiments at the end of the year. But anyway, that's it for this week. Thanks very much for watching, as always. Let me know your comments below, and hopefully I will see you on the next video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.